I have spent years interviewing candidates, and you might be surprised at how easy it is to tell who is hireable and who isn't. Being hireable means you have a better shot at getting the job that you want. The interview will be a lot smoother, and you will look professional, honest, and of course, confident. The resume, it gets you to the interview, but it's how the interview will pan out that will get you hired. In this video, I'm going to give you my 5-step process to make you hireable and get the job that you want. So let's jump right in. Hi everyone, welcome back. And if you're new here, thank you so much for joining. I'm Lara, and on this channel, I make videos on how to build your career and provide you the tools you need to land the job that you want. Go ahead and click that subscribe button so you don't miss out each week when I post new videos. With my 5 steps, I want you to think of it like a quick training course. As a career coach, I want to provide you solutions that are possibly missing when it comes to your interview. Maybe you're thinking that something is falling short when you're in there, and I want to help you make you more hireable. And I can tell you that my steps are 100% doable. So let's get you more hireable. Step number 1, dress for the job that you want. You would be surprised at how many candidates still get this one wrong. People don't lose opportunities because they're overdressed, but rather you'll have a harder time convincing that hiring manager or recruiter that you are hireable. In your interview, you have 3 seconds of your first impression on how you look to either create a positive or negative experience. Step number 2, honest and focused resume. About 75% of companies are now using an applicant tracking system to screen resume. Chances are that the recruiter and hiring manager are seeing hundreds of resumes go through, and if you're selected through ATS, then this could be the first time that they're seeing your resume. Make sure that it's focused, honest, clean, tidy, organized, and of course, make sure that it's customized to the company. I know what you're thinking. You don't want to be customizing every single resume, but I want you to think of it this way. Do you want to send out 100 resumes, or do you want to custom make 10 resumes, get interviews, and then actually get those jobs? I know when I've been interviewing candidates and I see that the resume is custom made, it shows me that they're serious, that they're making that effort, and it shows that they're more hireable. Step number 3, study your resume inside and out. When you're talking about your experience and your qualifications, you want to make sure that you sound confident. That hiring manager or recruiter have your resume right in front of them, so they're going to ask you questions to back up what you have listed. If you've listed a skill and a qualification that you can't remember and you draw blank, it will show that you're not honest. I tell everybody, make sure that you study that resume. You want to be confident when you're answering your questions. Now you've made it this far, so you want to make sure that you don't forget what you've listed. Step number 4, ask questions. This is where you get to ask a few questions at the end of your interview to show how serious you are about this company. It also gives them an idea of how interested, enthusiastic, and eager you are to join their team. It also is a chance to highlight qualities about yourself that are not necessarily covered in those standard questions that were already asked. This is one of my favorite parts of an interview because it gives me a chance to see the personality and thoughtfulness of a candidate. I want to tell you a quick story. I had previously interviewed a candidate who had done their research and asked me a question about a women in leadership program that I was mentoring. I was super impressed and I had a big smile on my face because not only was this question thoughtful, but they had done the research and were serious about the job. And of course, it proved to me that they are hireable. I have previously done a video about questions you can ask in an interview, and I will link it below so that you can go back and reference those questions and use them when you have your interview. Step number 5, your smile. I know you're thinking this is an easy one, but let me back it up with some facts. To put in perspective, 55% of our communication is nonverbal, and 75% of candidates who smile and build that positive rapport are more likely to be successful in an interview. Having that genuine smile indicates that you're a positive person, and companies want to foster positivity in the workplace. Bringing that influence will help you stand out. I am positive that if you focus on these 5 steps, you will stand out and you will become more hireable. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, please give me a like, and I would love for you to subscribe so we can stay connected each week when I post new videos. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.